Hey, Don here. Okay, so let me make sure I'm still recording. Sometimes it quits. All right, looks like it's gonna work as long as I don't project things up. I got this little. This is a controller. It's actually a modem, and a controller for a medical scale. And it belongs to my mom. And the power supply is laying here. It's she showed it to me. You know, the wire was hanging on by a thread. And as soon as I just kind of bent it just a little, it broke right off. They were both broke and probably could short out. You know, they were right next. I split them apart. They were together. I've got that taped on there so as not to lose it, but it's a regular barrel connector. It's fairly, I don't know, it's at least 10 years old. And anyway, the power supply, everything's upside down. But the power supply is, let's see, let me make sure I say it right. 8.5 volts DC, 1 amp, 110 volt. Or 120, says 120. A lot of them say 110, but 120 VAC, 60 hertz input, 13 watt. So anyway, I first thing I noticed, you know, I thought, okay, I tested it, it was dead. Wouldn't put nothing out. So the first thing I noticed was no markings anywhere on the barrel connector. Sometimes I can magnify stuff and it works pretty good. Sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes my lights, I'm usually in a different spot in the room. But anyway, there's no markings. And under the tape, you know, there's where that is. There's no markings there. There's no picture here showing. Nothing on the tag showing, you know, usually a little drawing showing the pinout, the polarity of the connector. And, you know, a lot of them are, positive in the middle and negative on the outside, on the, I know all the terms, I just always forget them right when I want to say them. On the barrel, I'll just say. I thought, okay, I need to get this thing and look at it. Well, I didn't. She was asleep. I think it was even late at night. I guess, but that way's better. But so I thought, well, I'll just look on the back of the. Trying to get it out of the light. You know, I'll look on the back and it'll be marked. Well, it's not. Not at all. There's a picture telling you that's where you plug it in. There's the modem connection. It's supposed to communicate to the outside world, and then it has a sort of like an S video connector. It has, well, actually, I think it is, but it uses a lot more pins, I think. Well, I looked in the cable, still in yonder. I didn't bring the scale or that with me, but that's where you plug it, the scale in is right there. And so this actually says has a volume. You can listen to it. Maybe it speak. I don't know if it speaks out your weight or if it just so you can hear the modem when it's connected. But somewhere on there it said, I looked it up, couldn't find anything about it. But, oh, well, what I was going to say, it says on here somewhere, made in America. Oh, down there on the tag, made in the USA. So, but the power supply says made in China. So I thought, well, heck, I can take that apart pretty quick and see where the pinouts are, because I kind of forgot. I was looking one, I thought, well, I'm gonna look it up, and I found one, and the closest thing I could find with the right size of barrel, I had, you know, I got my calipers and measured it in American inches and then converted it to foreign millimeters. That's kind of a worldwide joke if you didn't get that, but on interwebs, as they like to say. I got this one, and it is closest thing I could get, and I think it'll be all right. It's having to read it off of here. can't even, it's too little for me to see it. Well, that and the reflection. Okay, input 100 to 240 volts, 50 to 60 hertz. And output 9 volts, 1 amp. And it is positive in the center and negative on the outside. The ground in which is, well, I can't get it to show it, but just too many reflections where I'm set up here. But anyway, trust me, I'm not lying. I'm not Lex Luthor. So, I'm going to take it out of there. I haven't tested this new one either yet. See what exactly what voltage it puts out, but I'll try. I'll do that here in a minute. But I'm going to take this apart and see what the, I guess the best thing to do is to stand up. I was going to sit down in my chair and get comfortable, but this, if I'm not standing up, I can't see the phone to see which way's which. I thought the phone would allow you to flip the picture. A lot of your webcams all do that, you know. But it wouldn't allow me to do that. All you can see is my hands like that, but well. At least I'm not doing a handheld shaky cam this time. But yeah, it looks pretty easy to take apart. Four screws. Those screws in the legs probably just hold components on, if anything. There are actually 6 screws on the legs. Or stobbers. These are stobbers, and there's an actual leg down here that flips up. I didn't try flipping it, but you can have it laying flat. And that right there, that's really interesting. It says something on it. What does it say? It just says a Lear. That's the brand name. I'm pretty sure that's for resetting it. I didn't remember to look and find the hole. Somewhere there's probably a hole in it where you can poke that and reset it. Oh, there's a screw for something on the side there. Oh, that's it. It's just a hole. It's not a screw. See, I can't see. It looked like a Phillips head screw until I can feel that it's wanting to come apart right now. Yeah, okay. Just one little connector. That's in what I want to know. Oh, how cool. Oh, that's cool. Move this stuff. I want to show this first. I don't know, I just like circuit boards. A little dust in there, but let's see if this light does any good or any good or any bad there. If it'll stay. There. So, if I was Dave, the EEV guy, then I would sit here and tell you what all these chips are. But I'm not Dave, and I'm not an electronics engineer. I could read numbers off there if I could read upside down. But I think it's cool. I've learned a heck of a lot watching his videos. Thanks, Dave. I've always loved electronics, but I was never good at math, and they told me I had to be good at math to go to electronics school. So instead, I was a carpenter and a maintenance mechanic and all different things. Okay, so worked in an aircraft factory building F-16s, working on parts for F-111s. Okay, now here's my thing. I don't know. Let me turn that light off. I think that aluminum is shining so much. It makes it where I can't see. Okay, there's a. How about that? I mean, the connectors actually have little RJ45s that you can just take out. And to get where I can see that, I'm going to take that out. Oh, that goes from here, from that input. Oh, it's a pass. One of them's a pass through to go to your phone, if you so you don't need a splitter. But that goes. Oh, that just goes around. All it does is go around. That's RJ45. Goes around to this one to this one. How about that? Simplicity. Okay, so I still can't see it. Like in the top of my head. Dang it, I can't see. Well, it's not one of those where you can see it so perfectly easily. It's all closed in. It's actually made pretty well. Looks like it could be. Has a third unused third leg there, unused pin. Looks like it could be used for two or three wire type of a connection. So that's kind of surprising for a barrel connector. There's a red wire. Ah, that is the center. Okay, that goes around. It's at an angle. And it looks like it goes right to the center of that thing. Usually you can just tell by the position they're in. So, this is where I need to get out my meter and check for continuity on what's what. Okay, so how do I want to do this? Let's see. I want to have it to where I can. I want to try to keep it in the picture, but I also have to have it where I can. Yeah, I'm gonna have to turn it this way. Put my meter up here. And I'll put it in continuity testing. Once I get it on, I guess I can. Well, it doesn't matter. I'm not going to read out any voltage or anything. I keep telling myself, remember to flip it for the video. But I'll just put it on continuity. Let's see. Select. Makes that piddly little beep. But I should get off of that one. That I think is the. I wonder if that light will help.
Can I interrupt you?
Yeah, you startled me.
Looks like my computer's hung up again.
Okay, I'll be in there in a minute. I'm right in the middle of something. Well, Mom says her computer's hung up. It's probably not hung up, it never really hangs up. But it's running Fedora 14. Still running Fedora 14. I still need to upgrade that. Here I am fiddling with this. But very dependable. Okay. Yeah, I think that. I don't know if that helps that much or not. See, the good thing about light is it helps you see. The bad thing about light is it blinds you because it's gets right in my eyes. Yeah, that one is the negative. That light, that reflection, it's not so good either. Okay. Trying to get where I can. I think I'm going to have to use the magnifying glass to see. It's pitiful when you get to where you can't see nothing. I think I'm touching it. I still can't see to tell. Oh! Oh, that one helps. Yeah. I still kind of half guessing, but if it beeps when I touch that middle pin, I'll know. I'm not touching it. At least I'm not checking for voltage, just checking for continuity, so can't sort it out. Of course you could break something. I heard something make a noise. I just cannot see where. where it's going. I'm curious if this other one's connected to. It's not connected to the sitter pin, I don't imagine. I'm just curious. Yeah, it's connected to the ground.
Or what I can I always consider those the ground, even though they're not
always the ground. So maybe that light will help me. If it would come over this way more, it would really be good. If it would stay up. Let me get over here and see if I can make it stay up higher. And aim it that way at the same time. Maybe that'll work. I don't know. Now I can just use the magnifying glass, but no. That just blinds me again. So all it's doing is blinding me. Okay. Wires, I don't want to bend around on those wires real hard. They're kind of in the way. There's only one direction that I can get in there. That's from right there. Ow. I think it's these big old, you know, they're kind of good, you know, all that plastic, you can't short them out easy, but they're so short, you can't, it's too fat to go into places. Sometimes they're too short to go down in things, and they're very sharp, and I'm always poking myself with them. I mean, it's good sometimes you want them sharp. I just need another couple more sets of different types. Now that looks to me like I would, well, of course, when I sit down, it moved all over the place. Well, but I'm going to quit because with that, because by process of elimination, well, let's try this. Maybe if I quit worrying about the video and just worry about me being able to do this, by process of elimination, I could unplug that. Get that out of the way. By the elimination process, that should be the center pin. I mean, there's only two, right? So, but sometimes I'm stubborn about making something happen just because I want to do it. It's not going out of my way. Okay, now, yeah, I've been near it, but just not. Should beep now. Yeah. Okay, so that's the red wire. So, you know, unless they decided to swap colors, I always say there's no such thing as color codes because nobody follows them, but sometimes people make the red wire hot. Sometimes they make the yellow wire hot. If you're in a computer, that'd be 12 volts. And if yellow, red would be 5 volts. And, blue? Well, depends on what color the manufacturer wants to use. One other color would be 3.5 volts. So, I'm going to say that it's safe to plug me up. Now, it does wiggle a little, but I think it's going to make a connection. So, I think it's going to be safe to plug this in and try it out. I didn't want to have it short, you know, short and going backwards and blowing this thing out, this fine piece of equipment out. So, because there wasn't anything wrong with it other than that, from what I've been told, it worked. And I mean, it was pretty obvious there. Okay, so put you back. Uh-oh. Always pay attention. Oh, good. Always pay attention when you unplug things. There's another empty connector. Can you see that? Another inked one on one, that one there, and then there's that one. But I can tell right now that this only goes, sometimes you have to resort to going back to which way your wires were kind of bent, but this one's got about four pins, and the other one's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, so you can't get that wrong unless you really try hard somehow. Oh yeah, there we go. So, and I'm just gonna, sometimes you wanna, I could plug it in, open it up, oh, just to see what it does. I think I will, but, yeah, I think I will. No, I won't. You just risk shorting it out. I'll put it back together. Well, I could just set it in there. Let's see. Okay. Toshiba TC5070L. I'm not going to try to read all those numbers. Okay, so anyway. Pretty neat. I'm going to put this back on here. And I'll probably, the screws are really easy to get on and off, so if I needed them off. Make sure I'm getting everything right. And then I'm gonna go help Mom with her computer, and then I'll come back and finish this. Okay. Leave that like it is. Okay, I'll be back.